Good morning, aquarium fans. quick review on what I did to my high-tech tank this week. Main topic is water circulation. I picked up the Hydor Nano 240. I could have picked up the Hydor Nano 425 for about $3 more. You get a lot more flow rate for $3, but I didn't. Here's why. So here's our Hydor Nano 240, just to give you an idea how big it is. It's about 3 to 4 inches front to back, suction cup mounted with a magnet to the tank. It's the other end, it's a magnet. So I got the 240 instead of the 400 because I wanted a nice gentle current flowing through the tank. I don't want any excessive flow that the fish either wouldn't appreciate or the plants wouldn't appreciate. Now, if you've got a river environment, you'll want that, but I want it just a nice gentle flow through the tank. What I'll probably will do is add another 240 in this corner. That'll give me 480 gallons per hour from the Hydors, and I've got about 380 gallons per hour coming from my fluval 406 canister filter. So that'll give me a little bit more than 10 times flow per gallon, or flow rate per hour. So we'll be turning over the tank 10 times per hour. Why do we want to do that? A couple of reasons. First of all, we don't want any dead spots in the tank. Now, with just having one canister filter, I'm going to turn off this light. Without having just the canister filter shooting out one way, which I have it shooting just forward to the tank, it may miss some spots. Dead spots can lead to algae growth. So we definitely do not want any dead spots in the tank because we don't want to deal with algae. Number two, we want to get CO2 to all areas of the tank. So the CO2 we have coming out of our bubble counter here, it looks like it's running, which is accumulating bubbles in one area. But in any event, we want to make sure that our CO2 that we're creating over here gets circulated throughout the entire tank so everybody gets their taste of CO2. So we've got an equilibrium of, CO2 flowing through the tank. So look at that nice gentle swaying of the plants. That's nice. I like that. That's nice. What is my dog doing? You're eating a bone, okay. Two, nutrients. Same thing. We want nutrients to get to all parts of the tank. Same reason as CO2. We're going to be dosing this eventually with trace elements and macro elements, fertilizers. So we want to make sure they get to all plants in the tank. We don't want any dead and decaying leaves hiding in any dead spot in a corner. Again, that will create algae. So those are the reasons. Also, I've read that when the plants are absorbing CO2 and the nutrients, it's not just by touching the leaves. The flow of the current across the leaves actually helps it become easier for the plants to absorb the nutrients and the CO2 that we're adding. So in theory, we can add less CO2 and nutrients. Now that's something I read in a blog. But anyhow, it sounds good. Again, experiment. This is a hobby. This is fun. You know, this is fun. Try something. See what works for you. If it works, do it. So that's the update. Water circulation. Hope you like the video. Thumbs up, thumbs down. Comments, questions. Subscribe. Thanks for watching.